years of growth and success. In 2011, I still want to be the third national president of this great association. In the group message to the association that year, Captain Idris Wada emphasized the need for the Igala community to work in harmony in order to foster unity and encourage the spirit of community. In a similar vein, the keynote address speaker that year, Dr. Paul Ochedi, also challenged us to do more in community service. My team and I, meaning the executive, National Executive Committee, embraced that challenge and made service the cornerstone of our administration right from the start. In fact, we adopted the motto, exemplary service, and communication became our tool. Someone once said, if you build it, they will come. Over the next 4 years, we worked tirelessly to be transparent, expand our membership base, encourage member participation in decision-making, and win members' trust. Today, we are proud to say that paid membership has increased by more than two-thirds, the highest has ever been. This annual gathering now draws a large pool of participants from across North America and Nigeria, I would say. By also extending invitations to Igalas in Nigeria to dialogue with us at this conference, many now have an opportunity to come to the United States for the very first time. We highly empowered our board members and encouraged the various chapter leaders to get involved in the highest level of government through regular joint meetings, information sharing, and collaboration. That has been the cornerstone of our administration and what has helped us to really propel the institution to where we are today. I am especially proud of our National Executive Committee, and wish to acknowledge each and every one of them for a great team effort. I appreciate every one of you for the personal sacrifices you've made to make this association what it is today. And for that, I'd like to recognize them by asking them to stand up really quick. The Vice President, Financial Secretary, the Treasurer, are you the House? Please stand up to be recognized. Are you the House, the Secretary? That's the Secretary, Financial Secretary, Mr. Kiko. The Vice President. My Vice President is missing. The Treasurer, I believe she's out there collecting payments. Member of the Membership Committee, Omaye Kachi, Udama Kachi, and Association of the Gugwini today. Member made the big habit of all the people who are Chita Kachi. Okay, I wish to thank my own father, Alaji Akobo Akuelalo, who is unable to join us here today. I wish he was here to see this, but I'm thanking him for instilling in me the virtues of integrity and humility. My husband and my best friend, Dr. Augustine Osage, I'm going to embarrass him a little bit. Can you please stand up to the tonight? Thank you. I honor you for your unwavering love. To our children, I say go out and make a big difference in the world. My personal thanks goes to His Excellency, the Governor of Kogi State, as well as the First Lady, for all the support they've given this association over the past 4 years. I'm especially humbled by the presence of our Royal Father at this occasion. Last year, Her Royal Highness the Queen was at this annual conference in Maryland to represent him. This year, Akabayo has personally traveled all the way from the Royal Palace at Ida to address the Igala people in the diaspora. It's an honor of a lifetime.
Commander, I think probably is important, and this is the important card recognized. I want my call all the way from Nigeria. I know our campaign within the US is very important, but I said I want my queen Nigeria, I won't go out to do meeting today. Now I think I'm going to be Nigeria as a speaker for this meeting, my one, and I just for recognition. I want my queen Nigeria, Chakalu, please, can you just have a recognition? Okay. Another round of applause for them, please. Thank you. Then I book my new mark almost every year. Oh, my boss, you did it. It won't come out today, it's a young kid. It's a why you are to be in a Chakadu. Imagine you go back, we still want to just give time for our royal father to essentially address the children. This is definitely a very historic occasion for us as Igala people in diaspora. It is not very often that you get that opportunity to be able to be addressed by the father of an entire kingdom. So it's a very, very historic moment for us. It's a rare opportunity, and we sincerely appreciate our father for taking the time to come all the way from Ida to come and address this occasion. So this is a time we're going to live for him. So I will now call on our father, His Royal Majesty, the Attorney of Igala, Dr. Idako Michael Ahmed Oboni II, as he addresses his children in the US and Canada. So can we just give a special greeting to our royal father as he sets out to address his children.
Well, I shall start by saying to God really glory. For keeping you here and bringing me to join you. I decided to speak in English because I'm representing the ancestors and I should be speaking in the language of the ancestors. But having put so many protocol behind me, I decided to speak in a foreign language. Even so, I'm supposed to speak in Ghana and somebody else will translate in English. Well, there are so many doctors here who are versed in English, so I should have been speaking in Baraka. But to show you that I'm a Northern Akan. From my palace to this place, I have broken the rules of the excellent journey. And what I'm breaking one, I should break to the last one. So, my children in this world, you are all welcome. I'm sorry to come and see you. See you in person. See how you are faring. And to bring the spirits of our ancestors to you. I'm presenting the number one Igala citizen in the whole world. And I will present it not only the living, but I'm presenting the dead. our ancestors. So what I talk is guided by the spirits of our ancestors. That is why I refuse to make any official written speech. Personally, I'm not used to writing speeches. If I write a speech and I start to read it, once or twice I will negate. And then to come back and start where I started becomes a problem. So maybe because I'm guided by the spirit, that's why I'm like that. So this accepts my indirect apology. Writing a speech so that you can go through it. Now, I have been welcomed tremendously in this part of the world. This is my first time of crossing the Pacific or Atlantic to this side of the world. I've never been to this side. Naturally, we are guided by a lot of protocol. That is the protocol of the entire Ghana. We are by the River Niger in Nigeria, West Africa. But Atta is the back from even crossing the smallest stream in the Kenu. Talking of the River Niger, and then talking of the seas to this place. So I've broken some of the rules. But I must thank you, you're all very, very well. I was given a first class welcome at the airport. And very beautiful day, beautiful flowers, market flowers. I was so happy. And I saw my people getting dressed. I'm happy. That means the place you are sojourning outside your shows is also reflecting in their appearance. So I'm happy. And then it is my duty on you to keep the laws of the land where you are residing. So I implore you to keep their laws, obey all their rules and regulations, no matter how minute. You keep it. There's an adage in Ghana that says, "Ane kuga kuga, ane kuga kuga, ane." The world is all full of unbelieving ground. But what you see this is very settled. Ane the dodo, umango dodo. This place has received you, has given you shelter, has given you means of livelihood, has given you so much. So respect the land as a farm. Now that we have some populated Igalas here, I mean in the US, not in history only, it behooves on you that you should also remember those at home. Well, as Nigeria is developing, other parts are developing as well. But most especially, our part of Kogi State is not so good to write home about. There's a lot of poverty on the ground. There's a lot of ignorance on the ground. There's a lot of misgivings on the ground. There's a lot of rancor on the ground. The law we used to manifest before, during the time of our fathers and the grandfathers, is no more with us. We are no longer our brothers' keepers. These days, it is survival of the fittest, which is not good for us. So since we are here, outside here, in the land of opportunity, you should exploit all the action that comes your way so that it reflects on those at home. Personally, I've just come on board. About 2 years plus, I'm in the 3rd year, and we through the help of some good pals, I was able to get some good ophthalmologists. I said, what do you call them? Ophthalmologists. So I got two of them, the best in Nigeria, Dr. Abu and Dr. Male. Dr. Male is based in Abuja, he's the best in Abuja today. Dr. Abu is based in Kano, he's the best in Kano. So I get two of them, they come home once in a while. And then they conduct free surgical operations for those with cataracts. So And they said, just three days before the whole is over. And the God grows. But the impact they have created on the pool is tremendous. So I would like you here, in this place, some of the professionals here, not only medicine, should be able to arrange, and then once in a year, you go home to your source, the roots, where you go from. Then show them that I'm still part of you, and you give them the best you have. Money is not everything, but the service is anything less. I'm not talking of only medicine, not just medicine. If I am a good motivational speaker, this is very good. Make the people gather them, tell them, in the presence of speaking to them, you wipe out the ignorance from their faces. You make them have hope for tomorrow. All is not lost. Until you are defeated within yourself. So this is really something you should be able to leverage for future, for years ahead of us. So that we touch the people at all. They are there. This place is quite a long distance from home. And then it will be very difficult for them to really access up to this place. But you that are here, and you see the world, you see how America, out of the ocean, the state they have built, this place would like to be. This place should reflect that too, especially we from overseas leader people. The distance of about, say, 10 kilometers, who should be, other demonstrators, not cost more than, say, or whatever it is. So it looks like very few places we have clean drinking water. We can access medical facilities in the so-called towns. Every person in the village having problems, fairly women, special places. They are left to their face. To either die or be saved by somebody. So this is the scenario at all. We should labor and think and discuss among ourselves so that we change this at all. If we can make some trips home, as I said, this one or twice or even 10 trips will make some changes. We at home will not be waiting with legs crossed and hands crossed, waiting for you to bring the goodies from there. No, we are on our part. We will be serving within our reach to make sure that we develop our home. For you to come and see the surprise that the home we left is changing. Now, on my part, as head of the traditional government of Igala people, head of lands, head of the political, whatever, traditional, whatever, this is on my part to restore what used to be our binding factor that brought us together. That is our traditions and culture that were neglected for no good cause, for selfish reasons. This was the result. That was why, when I was being prorated, I said to go bullets. I started from Gwalao, a 16-mile distance from Ida. After I said, all of you have seen the field, so I think it's a test story. So, you see it. So, and then I do full tradition to place this one to present the show of the to make the hearing. Because at the last attack, I won the hearing for the offer. premises of it is very like this. Before, when we used to go to war, the war must begin from the front of the gates, which we call Alam, and it must terminate at the front of the gates. Festivals, all the festivals, begin from the gates, and it must terminate at the gates. Then when we come inside, it is people's palace. So, very soon, by the time we put that together, you and your part, you and your part, we play a part at all. Then, the time will come. When we say, look, we will send two delegations to that the leader will send a single group. Because we witnessed so many things. I, for one, have not seen how that test was projected. That's what we're doing when I started with it. But I say, I was full of the process. In my own being projected, those of my age and those the younger ones, the stories, I can't tell you how it is. That's another aspect of our culture. Which of those who's right? At the point, I'm running arguments. I shouldn't do this, don't do that, which includes chasing my ears to look like a woman. At least if I can be a woman, I'm going to be one of the oldest women. So, I'm not trying to enhance my youth in books. So, but this is tradition. I told the governor, I said to the governor, if you see my nose, yes, I do as this. It means piercing it with very much iron. I hold my nose, I won't break. Then they pierce it upwards of downwards. If it looks like what the attack was before, let's do like that. So I said the message across. I'm sending across the message that, look, I'm going to follow a straight line. I am not going to go anywhere. I don't push anywhere because I'm too big to push. I'm going to follow tradition. And there's an adage in the Gala that you know, when we go to war, palace are fire. You know what is very good of the time here? No matter how you want. There's a particle inside the flesh that I never feel. So I was going to go next and go what is it and make us look like the other one.
Amide!
It's a side opportunity to be a big race society. The other people I look at now, for instance, my friend sitting there was talking to speak English. I mean, I realized that. I felt it would be bad. But if I had taken food some 30 minutes ago, I would have vomited. But thank God, I was saved the drama. I was waiting so early, I didn't know the timing and so on before I came. So, you see, the most dangerous thing they say is half education. One of the most dangerous things about ourselves is. You are neither here nor there. A middle society. What? You don't look Western, you don't look African. I know so many people, when I was coming to this place, who go out of their way and shake my hand. Even at the airport here, the instance was somebody from Mexico came to me. He said it twice, then he started doing a long line. He said, he came again. He said to me, he said, look, I've not seen an African chief before. I look from Cameroon. I said, no, I'm from Nigeria. Nigeria is even better than Cameroon. So he said, look, I am what I am because
This is what God made me. And by the time I go to other culture, like the Yoruba, the Benin, you've seen culture in the making. Let's remember like that. God made us that way. And our language is given to us by God. It's spoken by God in heaven.
Yes.
So our culture should be with us. We should propagate it anywhere we go. So much for culture. Now, today, the modern day, how to survive depends on how far you can go in the society, the startups, the kind of life, and then investing, commerce, business, whatever, or engineering as well. Some of you are in that field. I will employ you to peace. Try to do your best. To be best of your, I mean, to be the at the height of all the career you've chosen, all the endeavor you make, the career, everything you do, do it very well. Because we have a place there, I know. If I have my way, I can say I'm a cadaver. This is to disappear from today and land in Iran. But I don't have that course. So, by the time you see what I'm saying, you excite my mind. We should always push ourselves to remember that we have a place. Until that place looks a bit like here, then we can say we have tried our best. But when there's a lot of despair, the ground is too white. Then, when you're going to come in there to a place of a very, very high standard, only to go home and descend to a very, very low standard. That is not good. Love is something that binds people together. It could be cultivated, but not something you can marry by force. You can't join them. And according to people, they say, it's only you join to graft priests. You don't join two people, so you don't graft them. So let's continue that love. Because the day I entered the palace, on the day of my promotion, 13th of March, 2013, before the gates, when we used to have a ceremony to the palace, I must announce the type of leadership I'm going to bring to the land. Before our seven prominent chiefs, I said that it's an old duty before I enter the palace. We had a snapshot, I don't know. It was sent to us by WhatsApp. Somebody has it here. One of the engineering. You have that slot. You have it. Okay. So that's the entrance of the palace. Then in that place, I told them. You give at least four to reflect the self. So, I'm constrained to give those four here for the benefit of those who are not there, who are not seeing the film, and who don't know the meaning of what it is. So, first and foremost, I tell you that I standing before you, you are trying to be to enter the palace. One of the names you know is Abochi, the Georgie. Ebony, Abochi, well, the region in Ghana means the back of the tree. You see the back of an Indian tree, but that is on the lawn there. Unless you touch it, it's from the Indian tree. The lawn from Mahogany, you know it. It means you get ready. You're going to see my father in there. Two.
Amide.
Two.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. And we are surrounded by lakes here, around this place. No matter how wide the fire is, it terminates at the edge of the lake.
Oh, yeah.
It possesses all our problems, all our misgivings, all our inadequacies, our priority marriage, to make sure it terminates in front of me. And so, then, it came on, if I remember, there was a person who remember, nobody, okay. It came on, it's a Ujului. I stand in front of you as a young man, a young old man in front of you, that I'm about to ascend this pool of my ancestors. I'm going into the inner chambers to present my ancestors. And where my people cry for help, I'll be there instantly. I will be there immediately to solve the problem. Immediately. Oh, I will say it's not so talented. So I'm here today because I do have problems here. And I'm going to solve it. With the power of God, I will shall bless.